Tirath Singh Rawat has resigned as the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand. In fact, there's a BJP Legislature Party meeting on Saturday. He has reached the Governor's House to hand over the resignation. Let's listen into the Uttarakhand Chief Minister.
सर, अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि संवैधानिक संकट था तो सल्ट एक ऐसी सीट थी क्योंकि आप 10 तारीख को आपने पद संभाला था।
राजनीतिक चूक कहाँ रह गई सर?
तो सल्ट चूक लड़ सकते थे ना सर?
सल्ट के समय मैं कोविड पॉजिटिव था, कोविड पॉजिटिव होने के कारण और समय नहीं था, लेकिन मैं कहता हूँ फिर आपको कि मुझे आज यहाँ तक जो मेरे पूर्व मित्रों ने पूछा है, मैं पुनः उनका हृदय से आभार प्रकट करना चाहता हूँ, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी का, माननीय राष्ट्रपति।
भाजपा ने उत्तराखंड का एक्सपेरिमेंट का अड्डा बना रखा है सर, क्या?
There's late night drama happening in Uttarakhand. The Chief Minister has reached the Governor's House to hand over his resignation. Perhaps for many journalists, they'll have to burn the midnight oil. I am joined by my colleague Sanket Upadhyay at this hour. Sanket, now that he has reached the Governor's House to join to hand over his resignation after having handing over to JP Nadda, what's the process? What will be the developments going ahead on Saturday?
Well, I think the suspense is pretty much over, because what was expected to happen on Saturday because of late night, I think the governor has given him the appointment and he's present there at the Raj Bhavan. The governor, Bebi Rani Maurya, will be in receipt of the resignation of the present Chief Minister, Tirath Singh Rawat. And the process from here on is that the legislature party, which is basically all the MLAs of the Bharatiya Janata Party, are going to meet. They're expected to meet at 4 p.m. on Saturday. There will be a central observer in the Agriculture Minister, Narendra Singh Tomar. And in his presence, these MLAs are going to choose their next leader. So whoever is the leader of the legislature party also goes on to become the chief minister. Now, interestingly, this time around, and contrary to what happened last time, where Tirath Singh Rawat, who was a MP from Pauri region, was paradropped and made the chief minister. This time around, what we are hearing is that the MLAs are going to choose a chief minister from among themselves, which means that one of the elected MLAs is going to be the chief minister and take over the reins. The likely names are Harat Singh Rawat, Dhan Singh Rawat, Satpal Maharaj, and a couple of others. These are being seen as front runners. But one of the reasons why, that was quoted, why Tirath Singh Rawat had to go, was a constitutional crisis, that because of COVID, there will be no by-election, which was a prerequisite for him to continue to be chief minister post the 10th of September. However, that was the election commission's prerogative, which it would have in any case done. So what appears is that the reason for his exit could be political, that the infighting that the BJP wanted ended with the departure of Trivendra Singh Rawat, the previous chief minister, and the entry of Tirath Singh Rawat, did not really work out. So another attempt has been made to bring in a third chief minister within 5 years by the BJP to end this infighting. Now, whether it is going to pay rich dividends come February or March 2022 when Uttarakhand goes to polls is anyone's guess at this moment. However, as far as the party is concerned, it is definitely a huge, it speaks volumes as far as the BJP's conviction with which it takes decisions, that it has to remove a chief minister within 4 months of him being sworn in.